a new development in Iran's defense capability. The Iranian Minister of Defense unveils the latest generation of indigenous cruise missiles built to enhance the Islamic Republic's power of deterrence. Officials say that mass production of the long-range surface-to-surface missile Dabt-Sumar has already started. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar is the most advanced cruise missile ever designed and built by experts at the Iranian Aerospace Industries Organization. One of the main features of the long-range missile is its ability to hit targets with great accuracy. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar enjoys modern technologies in navigation, propulsion, and structure. The homemade missile can hit a broad range of targets in all circumstances by relying on its high tactical capabilities, long survival over the battlefield, and radar-evading properties. During the inauguration ceremony, Iran's defense minister referred to the production of Sumar as an effective step in boosting the country's defense and deterrent power.
The designing and building of this weapon, whose navigation and propulsion systems and its structure enjoy complicated and new technologies, is seen as a wide stride taken to enhance the Islamic Republic of Iran's defensive and deterrence power.
This ceremony also included the mass delivery of two types of missiles, Qadr and Qiyam, to the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps IRGC Aerospace Force. The Qadr ballistic missile and the Qiyam mid-range missile are capable of carrying diverse types of blast fragmentation warheads. Upon delivering the missiles, Commander of IRGC Aerospace Force Brigadier General Amir Ali Hajizadeh said that Iran's missile technology advancements took place under sanctions imposed on the country. He added that his country's defense programs were non-negotiable.
The efforts that take place today by the young scientists and experts of our Islamic country are advancing under the harshest sanctions, which have so far failed to disrupt the progress of the Islamic Republic's defense program. I must add that we won't negotiate over defense issues and our ballistic missiles with anyone.
In recent years, Iran has made significant progress in its homegrown defense sector and has attained self-sufficiency in producing advanced military equipment and missile systems. Tehran says that its military might poses no threat to regional countries, and the Islamic Republic's defense doctrine is entirely based on deterrence. Amir Mehdi Kazemi, Press TV, Tehran. A new development in Iran's defense capability. The Iranian Minister of Defense unveils the latest generation of indigenous cruise missiles built to enhance the Islamic Republic's power of deterrence. Officials say that mass production of the long-range surface-to-surface missile Dabt-Sumar has already started. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar is the most advanced cruise missile ever designed and built by experts at the Iranian Aerospace Industries Organization. One of the main features of the long-range missile is its ability to hit targets with great accuracy. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar enjoys modern technologies in navigation, propulsion, and structure. The homemade missile can hit a broad range of targets in all circumstances by relying on its high tactical capabilities, long survival over the battlefield, and radar-evading properties. During the inauguration ceremony, Iran's defense minister referred to the production of Sumar as an effective step in boosting the country's defense and deterrent power.
The designing and building of this weapon, whose navigation and propulsion systems and its structure enjoy complicated and new technologies, is seen as a wide stride taken to enhance the Islamic Republic of Iran's defensive and deterrence power.
This ceremony also included the mass delivery of two types of missiles, Qadr and Qiyam, to the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps IRGC Aerospace Force. The Qadr ballistic missile and the Qiyam mid-range missile are capable of carrying diverse types of blast fragmentation warheads. Upon delivering the missiles, Commander of IRGC Aerospace Force Brigadier General Amir Ali Hajizadeh said that Iran's missile technology advancements took place under sanctions imposed on the country. He added that his country's defense programs were non-negotiable.
The efforts that take place today by the young scientists and experts of our Islamic country are advancing under the harshest sanctions, which have so far failed to disrupt the progress of the Islamic Republic's defense program. I must add that we won't negotiate over defense issues and our ballistic missiles with anyone.
In recent years, Iran has made significant progress in its homegrown defense sector and has attained self-sufficiency in producing advanced military equipment and missile systems. Tehran says that its military might poses no threat to regional countries, and the Islamic Republic's defense doctrine is entirely based on deterrence. امیر مهدی کاظمی پرس تی وی تهران A new development in Iran's defense capability. The Iranian Minister of Defense unveils the latest generation of indigenous cruise missiles built to enhance the Islamic Republic's power of deterrence. Officials say that mass production of the long-range surface-to-surface missile dubbed Sumar has already started. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar is the most advanced cruise missile ever designed and built by experts at the Iranian Aerospace Industries Organization. One of the main features of the long-range missile is its ability to hit targets with great accuracy. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar enjoys modern technologies in navigation, propulsion, and structure. The homemade missile can hit a broad range of targets in all circumstances by relying on its high tactical capabilities, long survival over the battlefield, and radar-evading properties. During the inauguration ceremony, Iran's defense minister referred to the production of Sumar as an effective step in boosting the country's defense and deterrent power.
The designing and building of this weapon, whose navigation and propulsion systems and its structure enjoy complicated and new technologies, is seen as a wide stride taken to enhance the Islamic Republic of Iran's defensive and deterrence power.
This ceremony also included the mass delivery of two types of missiles, Qadr and Qiyam, to the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps IRGC Aerospace Force. The Qadr ballistic missile and the Qiyam mid-range missile are capable of carrying diverse types of blast fragmentation warheads. Upon delivering the missiles, Commander of IRGC Aerospace Force Brigadier General Amir Ali Hajizadeh said that Iran's missile technology advancements took place under sanctions imposed on the country. He added that his country's defense programs were non-negotiable.
The efforts that take place today by the young scientists and experts of our Islamic country are advancing under the harshest sanctions, which have so far failed to disrupt the progress of the Islamic Republic's defense program. I must add that we won't negotiate over defense issues and our ballistic missiles with anyone.
In recent years, Iran has made significant progress in its homegrown defense sector and has attained self-sufficiency in producing advanced military equipment and missile systems. Tehran says that its military might poses no threat to regional countries, and the Islamic Republic's defense doctrine is entirely based on deterrence. Amir Mehdi Kazemi, Press TV, Tehran. A new development in Iran's defense capability. The Iranian Minister of Defense unveils the latest generation of indigenous cruise missiles built to enhance the Islamic Republic's power of deterrence. Officials say that mass production of the long-range surface-to-surface missile dubbed Sumar has already started. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar is the most advanced cruise missile ever designed and built by experts at the Iranian Aerospace Industries Organization. One of the main features of the long-range missile is its ability to hit targets with great accuracy. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar enjoys modern technologies in navigation, propulsion, and structure. The homemade missile can hit a broad range of targets in all circumstances by relying on its high tactical capabilities, long survival over the battlefield, and radar-evading properties. During the inauguration ceremony, Iran's defense minister referred to the production of Sumar as an effective step in boosting the country's defense and deterrent power.
The designing and building of this weapon, whose navigation and propulsion systems and its structure enjoy complicated and new technologies, is seen as a wide stride taken to enhance the Islamic Republic of Iran's defensive and deterrence power.
This ceremony also included the mass delivery of two types of missiles, Qadr and Qiyam, to the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps IRGC Aerospace Force. The Qadr ballistic missile and the Qiyam mid-range missile are capable of carrying diverse types of blast fragmentation warheads. Upon delivering the missiles, Commander of IRGC Aerospace Force Brigadier General Amir Ali Hajizadeh said that Iran's missile technology advancements took place under sanctions imposed on the country. He added that his country's defense programs were non-negotiable.
The efforts that take place today by the young scientists and experts of our Islamic country are advancing under the harshest sanctions, which have so far failed to disrupt the progress of the Islamic Republic's defense program. I must add that we won't negotiate over defense issues and our ballistic missiles with anyone.
In recent years, Iran has made significant progress in its homegrown defense sector and has attained self-sufficiency in producing advanced military equipment and missile systems. Tehran says that its military might poses no threat to regional countries, and the Islamic Republic's defense doctrine is entirely based on deterrence. Amir Mehdi Kazemi, Press TV, Tehran. A new development in Iran's defense capability. The Iranian Minister of Defense unveils the latest generation of indigenous cruise missiles built to enhance the Islamic Republic's power of deterrence. Officials say that mass production of the long-range surface-to-surface missile dubbed Sumar has already started. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar is the most advanced cruise missile ever designed and built by experts at the Iranian Airspace Industries Organization. One of the main features of the long-range missile is its ability to hit targets with great accuracy. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar enjoys modern technologies in navigation, propulsion, and structure. The homemade missile can hit a broad range of targets in all circumstances by relying on its high tactical capabilities, long survival over the battlefield, and radar-evading properties. During the inauguration ceremony, Iran's defense minister referred to the production of Sumar as an effective step in boosting the country's defense and deterrent power.
The designing and building of this weapon, whose navigation and propulsion systems and its structure enjoy complicated and new technologies, is seen as a wide stride taken to enhance the Islamic Republic of Iran's defensive and deterrence power.
This ceremony also included the mass delivery of two types of missiles, Qadr and Qiyam, to the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps IRGC Aerospace Force. The Qadr ballistic missile and the Qiyam mid-range missile are capable of carrying diverse types of blast fragmentation warheads. Upon delivering the missiles, Commander of IRGC Aerospace Force Brigadier General Amir Ali Hajizadeh said that Iran's missile technology advancements took place under sanctions imposed on the country. He added that his country's defense programs were non-negotiable.
The efforts that take place today by the young scientists and experts of our Islamic country are advancing under the harshest sanctions, which have so far failed to disrupt the progress of the Islamic Republic's defense program. I must add that we won't negotiate over defense issues and our ballistic missiles with anyone.
In recent years, Iran has made significant progress in its homegrown defense sector and has attained self-sufficiency in producing advanced military equipment and missile systems. Tehran says that its military might poses no threat to regional countries, and the Islamic Republic's defense doctrine is entirely based on deterrence. Amir Mehdi Kazemi, Press TV, Tehran. A new development in Iran's defense capability. The Iranian Minister of Defense unveils the latest generation of indigenous cruise missiles built to enhance the Islamic Republic's power of deterrence. Officials say that mass production of the long-range surface-to-surface missile dubbed Sumar has already started. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar is the most advanced cruise missile ever designed and built by experts at the Iranian Airspace Industries Organization. One of the main features of the long-range missile is its ability to hit targets with great accuracy. According to Iran's defense ministry, the Sumar enjoys modern technologies in navigation, propulsion, and structure. The homemade missile can hit a broad range of targets in all circumstances by relying on its high tactical capabilities, long survival over the battlefield, and radar-evading properties. During the inauguration ceremony, Iran's defense minister referred to the production of Sumar as an effective step in boosting the country's defense and deterrent power.
The designing and building of this weapon, whose navigation and propulsion systems and its structure enjoy complicated and new technologies, is seen as a wide stride taken to enhance the Islamic Republic of Iran's defensive and deterrence power.
This ceremony also included the mass delivery of two types of missiles, Qadr and Qiyam, to the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps IRGC Aerospace Force. The Qadr ballistic missile and the Qiyam mid-range missile are capable of carrying diverse types of blast fragmentation warheads. Upon delivering the missiles, Commander of IRGC Aerospace Force Brigadier General Amir Ali Hajizadeh said that Iran's missile technology advancements took place under sanctions imposed on the country. He added that his country's defense programs were non-negotiable.
The efforts that take place today by the young scientists and experts of our Islamic country are advancing under the harshest sanctions, which have so far failed to disrupt the progress of the Islamic Republic's defense program. I must add that we won't negotiate over defense issues and our ballistic missiles with anyone.
In recent years, Iran has made significant progress in its homegrown defense sector and has attained self-sufficiency in producing advanced military equipment and missile systems. Tehran says that its military might poses no threat to regional countries and the